Okay, so today we have a really unusual review. And this is an opportunity, really, to teach your children about keeping honeybees, and that's with the world-famous line of Barbies. Barbie currently has over 180 careers, and I'm going to tell you right now, this is my favorite one. This is for ages 3 and up, and this Barbie is a beekeeper. So, let's go over the details of it, and I'll explain a little bit about beekeeping while we're looking at this Barbie setup. And there's some unusual aspects to this Barbie setup, and I'll go over that too. 180 plus careers. Girls can do anything. Guess what? There is no beekeeping Ken. I don't know what that's about. Anyway, make the world a sweeter place with Barbie. Beekeepers maintain bee colonies and hives where bees make honey. Bees also produce beeswax and so on. And this is an opportunity to introduce children to how that happens. And I'm just showing you the label on the box here, but we're actually going to look at the components. Now here's Barbie. She's got a hat on her head and she's got a bee veil. And the veil's pretty good. So it shows how beekeepers are going to keep those bees away from their face while they can still breathe and see through it, and that's what the veil does. She has a pretty nice bee suit. It's half a bee suit, and the veil is open in the back. You also have bee gloves. Bee gloves are important to protect your hands while you're working on the hive. Normally, bee gloves go about halfway up the forearm, but that's a pretty good representation. Barbie is also wearing boots, and she has her boots nice and tall, and her pant legs are nice and snug around the ankles so the bees don't crawl up her pant legs. Her bee suit has a labeling on it, and it's got little bees, and it's also got something that looks like she might belong to a bee club. I recommend that your little kids go to bee clubs too, so they can learn more from beekeepers. The veil is open in the back, and Barbie has a lot of hair. So this Barbie's blonde. They also come in a brunette version. These are her boots from the back. They have a little split there so that you can pull her shoes off and interchange them, of course, with other Barbie outfits, I'm sure. The bee top, and she's got her veil pulled back right now because the bees are probably pretty calm and they're not flying in her face. This is the full shot of Barbie. She's wearing denim pants. The top has a Velcro strip in the back, so interchangeable with all the other Barbie outfits. Now she has a beehive, and this beehive has a little roof on it and some other details we'll go over. Look, there's a glass window on the side, and what's interesting about this Barbie beehive, it's just like a Flow-Hive. It has a window, and what are we seeing here? There's a field bee that has come in, and it's on the comb there, and it's doing a little waggle dance, and the other bees are in a circle around it. They're learning from this field bee where the source of nectar is and where the source of pollen may be. And they do that by waggling, and they're waggling a lot more when it's farther away and a little less when it's something closer. So that's a great thing to show the kids. Here's another example. You can pull a frame. This is supposed to be a honey frame, and it has little hexagonal sides on it. That's great, just like a real honeycomb. There are some incomplete cells on the edges there, which bees would not do, but it's still cool. There's the best part. Look at the end of this beehive. It has a spout coming out. So this thing is modeled after a tap comb style, which is a flow hive. So all Barbie has to do, and notice she doesn't have her gloves on, because when you have a flow hive, you don't need one. And she puts her little honey bears there, and she's going to fill them up, and the honey's just going to come right out of the side of that beehive and into her honey jars. She's also not wearing her veil. She's not wearing her helmet, because if you have a flow hive, you stand behind it, and the bees are not bothered, and they're not going to go after Barbie. So this is a very interesting way for her to tend to her bees. If she were opening the hive and getting into the bees to look at them, she'd have to wear the veil. But for the honey collection, she doesn't need to. So here she is with her honey bears under her arm. What do you think she should do with them? Well, she's probably going to sell them. And you know, the bees work really hard for that honey. So I hope she sells them at a good price. There's a little cash register here. And I hope Barbie sells it for about $20 for a quart. And here's Barbie letting you know that she's proud of what her bees have done. And see the little holes on the roof there? Those are spots for bees to go. So again, this is a great outfit. It's a great introduction. It's a great way to teach your kids about bees and ask them what would they do? How should the bees be cared for? And see these little spots up here? Barbie's nothing without the bees. There they are. You get 5 bees with this set. There's also a little drawer in the back of the hive where you can keep your bees from getting lost. They include this little flower pot, and it has holes in the top too, so that you can put your bees on that and they can pretend to be getting nectar and pollen. So this is a great set. I'm going to be making a Christmas gift of this set to my niece. So Eloise, get ready. This is coming your way. And this is everything. I think it's a great series. I think it's fantastic that they have these careers for Barbie. And I think it's a wonderful way to take young kids and give them an introduction to beekeeping. And if they're interested, maybe even take them to a real bee yard and show them the bees. And then it will just be a great tie-in for what they're doing with their Barbie. So are Flow-Hives real? Could there be a real beehive that the honey just comes out of the back and goes right into the jar? You bet they are real, and you bet it does happen. And here's a Flow-Hive right here. This is a real beehive, and those are real combs of honey, and the honey is just coming right out of the back and going right into this half-gallon jar. A half a gallon of honey or more comes out of each of those frames. And there it is. Look at that. A half gallon of honey. Each bee spends its entire life collecting no more than a teaspoon of honey. So honey is very valuable, as are the bees. And beekeeping Barbie is just a great way to segue into teaching your kids about the environment, about the value of bees, and what we're going to get out of them. What can you do for bees? We'll plant flowers. That's a honeybee right there. Honeybees on asters, they're pollinators, they're going to make sure we have fruits and vegetables. And in return, the bees are going to make honey to feed their babies, and the pollen gets fed to the babies. And we have more bees and a better environment. Thanks for watching.